Hello out there, everyone. It's Mike McLean from the Section 8 Bible, the number one book ever written for Section 8 landlords. Hey out there, everyone. I know it's been a while since my last video, and I'm also aware that I start every video by telling you it's been a while since my last video. But anyway, I'm coming at you for two different reasons tonight. The first reason's real simple. It concerns Section 8 Bible Volume 3. Now, I know a lot of you people bought Volume 1 and Volume 2 off of Amazon. They're both available as an ebook form and a paperback form. As of tonight, we just got Volume 3 listed as a paperback and an ebook on Amazon. So if that's where you get all your books from, Amazon, you can jump back on there and order Volume 3 off of Amazon. If you like it, please give me a 5-star review. I hope you enjoy it. Also, I still sell the book on my website, which is www.section8bible.com. In my personal opinion, I think I sell a better quality book of Volume 3, but if you want to get it from Amazon, that's fine also, okay? Now, I'm going to get back into giving you some tips, and tonight's tip is going to be called Stealing with Your Eyes. Now, I'm always stealing with my eyes, and I'm going to tell you exactly what I mean by it, okay? All right, let's say a problem goes wrong in one of your rental properties, okay, and you got to call, whether you're calling a carpenter, an electrician, a plumber, whoever, you're going to call them over to take care of the problem. All right, let's just say, for instance, it's an electrician, okay, and you got a problem downstairs where the breaker box is arcing, okay. You call the electrician out, he says, I'm going to charge you $100 an hour. He comes over, goes down to the basement, he figures out the problem within, say, 45 minutes, he comes back up. You hand him the $100, he's on his way, everything's done, the problem's taken care of, but what did you learn? Nothing. You got the problem fixed, but you didn't learn a thing. And here's what I mean by stealing with your eyes, okay? What I do is when that electrician's on his way down the steps, I will follow him down the steps. Now, I know enough about electricity and plumbing. I know a lot about a lot of things in the homes, but there's always something that occurs every once in a while that stumps me, and I want to find out what the problem is. So once that electrician goes down the basement, I'm going to sit there and watch every move he makes. Reason being, the next time it happens, whether it's this house or another house, I'm going to know exactly what he did to eliminate the problem, and I'll start with that. Let's say the box was arcing, and he took the cover off and put his tester on. I'll watch exactly what he did, figure out exactly what he did, and I'll duplicate it on the next property, okay? Now, let me give you an example of something that really did happen, okay? About 15 years ago, there was an epidemic in Southwest Philly where everybody was buying properties that had, you know, you're buying them for bank foreclosures, and they've been sitting for a while, and all the copper was stolen out of the properties, all right? So the big thing 15 years ago, which was starting to come out, was a thing called PEX, which is plastic tubing. Instead of copper, you're replacing it with plastic tubing. Reason being, number one, it's cheaper, and number two, a crackhead's not going to break into your property to steal plastic. Once they break in, see the plastic PEX, there's nothing there for them to take. They'll move on and find a property that still has copper sitting in it. Anyway, the plumbers were getting a fortune back then, okay? They were charging unbelievable amount of money. Anyway, I call a plumber up. I say, hey, listen, I just purchased two properties. Let's make a deal here. I'm going to give you both properties to run the PEX in, okay? So he comes up with a deal. I pay for the material, and he's going to charge me $125 an hour for himself and his helper. That's $125, you know, not a piece, just $125 for him, and he's bringing a helper in with him. I said, okay. So at the time, I never ran PEX. I didn't even know what it was about. It was brand new. It was just coming out, okay? So he shows up on a Saturday morning. He comes over to my property. He goes down the basement, brings the PEX with him, brings all his tools and everything else with him. He goes in and starts hanging the PEX, and then there's a thing called a mana block, okay? And I'm looking at the mana block. A mana block is something where all the lines run into, okay? It's almost like a breaker box for water. So you can turn your toilet off from there. You can turn your water heater, anything that you have water lines running to, you can shut off from the mana block. A lot of people also call it a manifold. But anyway, I'm walking around behind him and his helper, and I'm trying to watch everything they do. He turns around and says to me, hey, pal, what are you going to do? Follow me around here all day? I said, yeah, I'm paying you. Don't you know the golden rule? The person with the gold makes the rules. I'm the person with the gold. I'm making the rules. I'm paying you. Yeah, that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to follow you around and watch you so I don't have to call you out again. He says, really? You're going to hang over my shoulder like a vulture? I said, wait a minute. You're charging me $125 an hour to glue plastic together, and you're calling me a vulture? I think you got the things here reversed a little bit. You're the vulture. You're killing me with $125 an hour. But anyway, needless to say, I said, hey, buddy, listen, if you don't like it, roll your pecs back up, take your mana block, hit the road. I'll find somebody else that'll let me watch him put the pecs in. So with that, of course, he's not going to lose the money. And but he's got a little attitude, which I don't really give a shit. I'll stand down there even if he's got an attitude and watch what he's doing. It's my house, it's my money, you get the point. All right. Anyway, he gets on that property and he moves on to the next property. The whole time we're going over to the next property, I'm saying, why the hell did I need that mana block? All the lines tie into it. Like I said, you could shut your toilet down from there, you could shut a faucet down from there. But I'm saying, wait a minute. If a faucet leaks, my tenant isn't going to go down and turn the mana block off. My tenant's going to pick the phone up and say, hey, Mike, the toilet's running, or hey, Mike, your faucet's running. You got a leak. So when we get to the next property, same rigmarole. He brings all his tools down, he brings the pecs down. And I said, hey, wait a minute, let me ask you something. Do I need that mana block? He says, yeah, you need it. I said, no, I don't think I do. I watched you do the whole project. Let's just eliminate the mana block and have one shut off. We'll run the line, the main, right in, and we'll eliminate the mana block. He scratches his head for a minute and says, you know what? I guess you don't need the mana block. So instead of having 50 shutoffs, I only have one shutoff. So if something leaks or runs, my tenant just got to go down and turn one ball valve off instead of 50 ball valves or whatever they got to do. You know what I mean? So I eliminate the mana block, which at the time, the mana blocks were going for like $200 or $225. Moral of the story, by the end of the day, I knew exactly how to do it. It's so easy. It's like stringing spaghetti together. It's the easiest thing you'd ever seen in your life, PEX. Second, I eliminated using a mana block just by watching this guy for one day. So for now on, I do all my pecs in all my properties, and I don't use a mana block. So I save 200 there. I save $125 an hour. I'm saving money across the board. And listen, you get your fair share of jerk offs that say, hey man, you got to be watching me. Yeah, I do. But a lot of guys, I mean, I'll bullshit with anybody when they come in. If they're nice or whatever, I'll sit there and bullshit with them. Hey, what's this? What's that? A lot of them explain it to you. They really don't care. You know what I mean? The guys that got enough work, hey, they'll tell you exactly what they're doing. They don't really care, and you'll learn something. So if you're going to be paying for something, you might as well learn something while they're there. You're going to have to be there anyway. So why not go down and watch them rather than sit upstairs and stay on your phone? You might as well learn a lesson. You're paying for it. Learn the lesson. Next time, you'll save the money. All right. I hope you enjoyed the tip. Once again, you can get Section 8 Bible Volume 3 on Amazon, and you can get it from my website, www.section8bible.com. I hope you enjoyed the tip, and I promise you, I will be back next week with another tip. I hope you enjoyed this one. Have a good night, and thanks for watching.